Hi guys, I hope you're thriving and doing really well and practicing radical self-care. I hope you're meditating and joining a spiritual community. I hope that you are taking great care of yourself, getting plenty of exercise, drinking lots of water, eating healthy foods, and I hope that you are connecting with other people who have either overcome narcissistic abuse or who are actively working on their codependence. In this video, I'm actually going to try to repeat a video that I was having technical issues with this morning. And in this video, it's why some of the reasons why narcissists cheat. You know, do all narcissists cheat? No. Most of them do, but not all. And then do people cheat that are not narcissistic? Absolutely. People can cheat for a number of different reasons, but the reasons that narcissists cheat is usually a little bit different than the reasons that other people cheat. So the number one reason that narcissists will cheat is probably narcissistic supply. They want attention. They want adoration. This is their drug of choice. They're addicted to it. They have an addiction to feeling special. So when people chase them and want them and go after them, it really makes them feel good about themselves and it bolsters their fragile ego, right? A single relationship is not going to give them what they need. It's not going to, give them that adulation over the long haul. Of course, somebody could totally love them, could totally be giving them all sorts of positive reinforcement, could adore them, right? But that supply gets boring to them over time. They like shiny new toys. So they want the new supply and they really like multiple sources of supply. Often if they're cheating, they like to put their primary source of supply up on a shelf and neglect that person, go after the new source of supply. And then maybe if they get bored with the new source of supply, they'll take their old toy down to fiddle with and play around with. So that is kind of how they work. So they're always looking elsewhere for new admirers, new people to worship them and give them validation and say, don't you know how wonderful you are? You're so amazing, that sort of thing, right? Another reason they cheat is an inflated ego. There's a lot of different research out there that suggests that narcissists are they're egomaniacal. They think very highly of themselves. They spend their lives thinking that they're superior to everyone else and that they're extremely desirable and above everyone else. They're superior, you're inferior. I don't know if this is how they really feel inside. I think inside they have a deep-seated inferiority and insecurity, but there's a mask of superiority. So sort of their defense mechanism is that they're superior. So they think that the rules do not apply to them. The rules of the minions, all the people that are boring, don't apply to them because they are profoundly special, right? They have this addiction to feeling special and to thinking that they're special and they're above others. So that's probably another reason why they cheat. Another reason is one of the three E's that Craig Malcolm talks about. It's the three E's of narcissism: entitlement, exploitation, and low empathy. A narcissist genuinely believes that they are deserving of things, more deserving of things than other people. They believe that they have the right to more than one partner having affairs. They're special. Remember, they just think they're very special. It's not a question of whether this is morally the right or wrong thing to do because they do not have to live by the rules that the rest of us live by, the standards of the lowly minions. They are superior. They are special. You are inferior. The rules just don't apply to them and they justify their physical and emotional infidelity. It's just how they operate. And they're very exploitative and they don't really care who it hurts or who gets affected. Also, that low empathy, they don't tap into the feelings that they cause other people. It doesn't occur to them that their cheating is going to hurt their spouse or their partner, is going to hurt their children or their stepchildren. It's going to hurt the affair partner's children. It's going to hurt the affair partner's spouse. It's going to hurt all the family members, all the friends. They don't really tap into this empathetic response of how other people are going to be affected by their actions. Because again, they don't take any personal responsibility for what they do. They blame their actions and behaviors on other people, typically on their scapegoat supply number one, right? So you're to blame. If they cheat, first of all, they'll deny and gaslight, right? But if they cheat and you caught them red-handed, then one way or the other, they're going to put it on you. They cheated because of you. Anyone who knows about cheating, the thing is that people are unfaithful because of who they are. It actually has nothing to do with the other person. The reason I was faithful in my marriage was because I made the decision and I wanted to maintain my integrity. When I was in my addiction and I was an alcoholic, I did cheat on people and it was horrific. And I felt actually quite a bit of guilt and remorse and shame around it. But I wasn't in touch with my empathy. I didn't have any integrity. So, you know, I got sober about 14 years ago. And in the process of that, now and in touch with my true self, I've made the decision that I want to live in integrity. So I want my actions to match my words. So if I committed to somebody and I married them and I said, I'm vowing to be faithful to you, then I'm going to keep my word because I want to maintain my own integrity. It actually has nothing to do with who I married. I want to feel, you know, decent about myself. I don't want to go against my own word. I don't want to make myself a liar. And I have remorse. I have guilt. I have empathy. So I don't want to hurt other people. It's crappy. I definitely don't want to. So that's part of the reason why I don't. Narcissists don't have those things in place. They're not in touch with their remorse, their shame, their guilt, their conscience. They don't seem to have those things. They just go about life and, you know, devouring whatever they want in the moment. And they don't really tap into any of those feelings of, they don't tend to even experience remorse or guilt. That's why they act so weird and stoic, and they can just go from one family to the next family, slide into that family seamlessly. It's the oddest thing you've ever seen. I've just never seen anything like it. So, those are some of the reasons that they cheat. Another reason they might cheat is poor impulse control. There's evidence to suggest there's a strong relationship between narcissism and impulsivity. Not all of the time, but sometimes narcissists can be very, very calculating, but other times they're very impulsive. So they get into a situation where they can secure some narcissistic supply through physical or sexual gratification, and they might find that urge irresistible. They don't have any regard to the consequences of their actions. They may cheat on a partner for no other reason than a profound lack of self-control. They can't control their own base impulses. Another reason that they may cheat is a high sex drive. A lot of them have a strong libido. There's a strong correlation between narcissism and pornography and sex addiction. A lot of narcissists are porn addicts or sex addicts. Sex for them is a source of supply, and it's a chance to prove their worth and how amazing they are. And, you know, they also use sex to self-soothe. For them, sex is like a drug. And when somebody hits them with that drug, they get all this validation from the sex. So sometimes it's because they have a sex addiction or a porn addiction, and that's all, you know, kind of intermingled with the way that they're seeking out sex with partners. So they, you know, the sex issues could, you know, be a reason, another reason why they cheat. A power trip. They like to feel control over others. They get off on the power of convincing people to do what they want them to do. Sex or other forms of physical or emotional compliance are pleasing to the narcissist. They also like to the challenge of attracting and seducing people, especially if that person is married. They love it because they get that person to leave their spouse and leave their family and destroy their family over them. It makes them feel really special. Like they're so special that person would actually leave their husband or wife for the narcissist. That's just a real turn on for a narcissist. You might even see that the narcissist could have been with that person when they were both single, but no, it's so much more fun to, you know, to use each for the sneakiness and the lying and the getting away with it and the, you know, the challenge of getting somebody to leave their partner or their committed relationship. But the duplicity is a part of it too. They often cheat because they love like spy games. They like the secrecy, the sneaking around, the getting away with it with their spouses, getting away with it at work if it's a work affair. They like to dupe their employers. They like to dupe their colleagues and have this sneaky sort of, you know, under the radar work affair. They really get off on that piece of it, is the sneakiness and the secrecy. They love to control more than one partner, and they may engage in multiple affairs or lead multiple lives with multiple different partners. These people have double, triple lives. To them, it proves that they're superior intellect because they can get away with it. They're more clever, they're more attractive, they're more likable. The rest of us, it's not that we don't do that because we don't want to get away with things like that. That makes us feel guilty. We have guilt and remorse to stop us. We don't get off on duping others. Duper's delight. They talk about that. That's something narcissists have. That is not something normal people have. Believe me, it isn't. Even normal people or addicts or whatever that cheat, they don't have that duper's delight where they're getting off on like duping somebody. They usually do self-destructive things and then they have remorse and guilt, right? Normal people. And then also a big reason why narcissists cheat is they don't treat people as human beings. They don't see people as human beings. They see people as sources of attention. People are merely objects to use and abuse. Other people's feelings do not matter. Their well-being is of no concern. A narcissist is pathologically self-centered. They care about themselves. And cheating on a partner is not really cheating in the eyes of a narcissist, because how can you cheat on one object with another object? They're just wash machines. People are just hamburgers. How can you cheat when everyone's just dehumanized? They're just objects to you. They're there for you for the three S's: sex, supply, servitude. That's why you have people. That's why a narcissist has people in their life, and money too. That's another factor. So I guess there's an M in there too, but these are some of the reasons why a narcissist might cheat. There's probably a million other reasons, but these are some of them. And you know, mostly they just don't have empathy. So they just don't care how other people get affected. A narcissist will typically lie, 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 deny, 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 gaslight, gaslight, gaslight. They will do that for a long time. The only time that they will admit what they did is if they're like caught red-handed. And even then, if they're caught red-handed, you will never get an apology from them. You will never get them to take personal responsibility. They will never tell you that they are sorry that they hurt you. They will never make amends. They will say, I cheated because you did X, Y, Z. That's what they do. So even if they're caught red-handed, they still don't take any personal responsibility for their cheating because they're cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Sorry, I'm just kind of having a fun time with this video, but these may be some of the reasons that you guys, you know, maybe this will resonate with you. Maybe you've been in one of these relationships and you suspect or you have proof that your partner cheated. If so, I'm so sorry. I'm so, so sorry. I feel your pain and it's not a fun thing, but you will heal. You will get over onto the other side and you will be stronger for it. Thanks so much and have a wonderful day. Bye.